Have you ever felt?
Are you listening? Damn.
Disabled equestrian slash dog trainer, but I'm not really doing anything equestrian. I'm a dog trainer today. Today wasn't actually the day I was gonna start this whole thing. I was gonna start it yesterday, but I'm not smart and I lost all of my footage from yesterday. I did manage to salvage a little bit of my riding footage from both my horses, so I'll put a little timestamp right here if you don't want to have to sit through all my rambling and the Q&A stuff, because you just want to say horses. I get that. So today, literally just gonna go food shopping, and I'm out with my dog, and I have like a Q&A thing that I'm gonna do, so it's hopefully not too boring, and it's gonna be the right footage at the end. That's what we're doing today.
Y'all wanna know a secret? All of this shit is so bad for your dog. None of it's good. Don't buy anything from a supermarket.
I figured out a way to conserve my energy.
I've ventured off. Ow. I'm venturing off on my own to try and find an SD card, and I just went past the aisle. I'm not smart. Oh my god.
I can get shortbread dogs. Holy shit.
Yes.
This is the makeup for the day. So we're going to go film a Q&A outside, but it's windy. And I don't want the wind to be picked up in the microphone. First question comes from an Instagram account called Representation in Riding, which is lovely. They highlight different people from different walks of life in horse riding. They said, this may be too personal, but what kind of disability do you have? So I currently only have one physical disability diagnosis, and that is fibromyalgia. Fibro is a pain condition, and no one really knows what it's caused by or what it is, but my body's in a lot of pain all the time. I get intermittent numbness, intermittent cramping, really painful pins and needles, sometimes it's so bad I can't walk. So that's my only official diagnosis, but I am being investigated for hypermobile Stanley syndrome and postural orthostatic tachycardia syndrome. I don't really want to go too much into those because, again, I haven't been diagnosed, it's just an investigation. But I have a few mental illnesses as well. I have depression, generalized anxiety, which means I just get anxious about everything. There's no like specific things, just everything. And PTSD. They asked a bunch of questions, so I'm just going to go through them. When did you start riding? I started riding in, I don't know what year it was, but I think I was about 10, 9 or 10. Hello. So we're going on 8 years-ish. What's your dream horse? Honestly, Duke, my current horse, but a little bit smaller.
In the arms of the
arthritis. Duke isn't actually my horse, I lease him. Black or brown tack? I like both. I'm actually looking for a dressage saddle at the moment, I want to go brown, but I currently ride in black tack. What are your goals as an equestrian? My goal used to be 1-star eventing before I got sick, but now it's more so just to ride and enjoy what I have and enjoy my time with my horses and have fun with that. These questions are from Nelly Atiko, who's my girlfriend. You should follow her. But she asked a few questions.
Ow! Shit, I just sat on a rock.
What is the most difficult challenge you face with your disabilities? That's a good question. I'm learning how to live again because, you know, I spent 16 years of my life living and being able to walk and not having my joints family and not having my hips dislocate and my shoulders and being able to walk around without being in pain, and then all of a sudden hormones happened and my body was like, ah, no. Just adjusting the way I work, adjusting the way I have to ride. Adjusting my goals has definitely been a massive challenge. As I said, my goal used to be 1-star, and it took me a really long time to give up that goal. I think I spent about a week just crying. What have you needed to change since being diagnosed with a chronic illness? I have had to change my work. I don't do private in-home sessions anymore, so I don't go out to people's houses and train their dogs there. I only do group sessions. All people can bring their dogs to my house, or I do private sessions at our facility. I've changed the way I have to ride. I have to bend my feet into the stirrup so they don't come out because they go numb. And I have to bend my stirrups to the girth. My leg is so unsteady because it's so weak. How do you train a dog from a wheelchair? Good question. I don't know. I'm still figuring it out. Favourite thing about Brandy. Brandy's my horse. She is a 16-year-old, 15'3", hand-tied chestnut thoroughbred mare. I think I love... She tests me, but she always looks after me. It's like she knows where my limits are, and I love that. She pushes me to be better and pushes me to help my own anxiety, because she has such severe anxiety I have to help her, but she still backs off when I need it, actually. How do you keep the motivation to still want to ride even though you are going through what you are going through? That is by jamie.er. So it's been really difficult. I love my horses and I love what I do, and I don't ride to, you know, compete or to win. I ride because I love it and because it's my passion. It is hard for my body. Like, I rode both my horses yesterday and I am in so much pain. I can't walk very much. I struggle to walk from inside the house to the backyard. I have my little trusty walking stick. His name is Pat Stick. Follow me on Instagram, wheels.and.hooves. Most awkward thing someone has said to you in regards to your wheelchair use? Ooh, good. There's a lot of things people do. Say, don't tell me it was a horse accident. I'm like, no. People tend to baby me a lot. One of the worst things is when I go into shops with someone else and I ask a person a question and they answer the question to the person I'm with. There's a lot of things people do. I want to make like an entire video about people, like stuff people have done and said to me. Favourite quality in a horse? I think a good brain. Now, Brandy is very anxious. She does have a good brain. She has a lovely personality. Duke, he has a fantastic brain. How have the people around you reacted to you being sick? A lot of people have started treating me differently. They treat me like I don't deserve the same respect as everyone else because I have a disability. And that's kind of the hardest thing, is that like I haven't changed at all in my personality. It's just my physical ability has changed, but I still make really bad puns. Biggest inspirations to keep riding. My horses. And that's a really annoying word. Being people in my life who have their own struggles, because everyone's going through their own shit, who has their own struggles and they're still riding. Like, my girlfriend is a big inspiration to me because she's going through so much and she's still riding. My doctors have pretty much said to me, look, we're not going to tell you to stop riding because we know you're not going to listen to us, but you shouldn't be riding. And I was like, okay, cool, not listening, still riding. Favorite sock? The secret sock. How's the new pony going? So Duke is the new pony. He's going well. I'm really happy with him. I've been waiting almost a year to see a neurologist. I love the public health system in Australia. Abby! Don't balk! That's illegal! How did you get a service dog? I have EDS and have been looking into it. I don't know how. So I'm not sure where this person's located, but I can only answer this question for Australia because I live in Australia and I'm not educated enough on the laws in other countries to give out information on how to do things. In Australia, there are three ways you can get a service dog or an assistance dog. Can the wind stop? Jesus. So, one is you can go to an organisation. Abby is both owner-trained and through an organisation. It's kind of weird that I know the organisation person, so I'll link some really good organisations for service dogs in Australia down in the description if you want to check those out. Two, you can go through a trainer. I can train service dogs. Hit me up. BSG Dog Training. We'll also link that. The only thing with individual trainers is they usually can't provide a documentation to say that your dog's completed the training. Or they can, but it probably won't stand up in court. An organisation is your best bet to go if you're planning on flying a lot with your dog. You require documentation in Australia. We don't require it, but they can ask for it. It's a bit of a grey area. Again, I'm not too educated on this, so I wouldn't. There's a few really good assistance dog groups on Facebook. Join those. The third option is the most difficult, and it is owner training. You can legally owner train your dog. The DDA, which is the Disability Discrimination Act of 1995, states that the only requirements for an assistance dog is that it needs to assist a person who has a disability. It needs to be hygienic, so it needs to be clean, it needs to be not shitting all over everybody, it needs to be not pissing everywhere, and it needs to be well behaved, needs to have basic obedience training. So legally, you can train your own as long as it is clean, it is well trained, and it does have a task that assists you. Why do you ride Brandy in a bitless bridle? So I kind of switch between bitless and with a bit with Brandy. It's about 50-50. I find she works better in the bitless. So she works better in the bitless, but I also have no issues with riding in a bit. I ride Duke in a bit, and I ride her in a bit about half the time. She works better in the bitless. I usually use the bitless when I'm having like a more chill ride, or I'm having a bareback ride, things like that. Or if I'm jumping as well, because you can use them in jumping. It's legal. I just find she's happier in it. What is your opinion on the straw ban? Right. Here's the thing. If you don't include everyone in a conversation, then you are going to be discriminatory and it is going to affect people negatively. If you don't include pretty much the biggest demographic of people that need to use straws in a conversation about whether we should ban straws, then you're going to affect people negatively and it's going to be not good. I use straws because I have seizures, I get severe tremors, I get cramps, sometimes my hand stops working, and so I can't afford to have my hand stop working and drop a glass. So I just think that disabled people, people with disabilities, people that use straws need to be included in the conversation about whether or not we should keep using straws. Feminism? Hell yeah. Horses or ponies? Ooh. I love ponies because it's sass, but I love horses because usually they can jump bigger. Favourite horse that you've owned? Brandy. Hands down. She's taught me how to deal with my own shit so that I can deal with her shit. I don't have words to describe her. She's just incredible. And I love her a lot. So I'm going to leave that there just because it's getting cold and I'm freezing my tits off. Hello! I hope you've enjoyed the Q&A. Hello. And it's not too boring for you. And if you have any more questions for future Q&As, just chuck them in the comments. I'll write them down with the username and I will answer them in a future one if I decide to do one. See you later. I just wanted to show something that was... Swear to God. Stay. So I just wanted to show you guys something that I thought was kind of cute. So I'm eating at the moment. Yes, I am eating out of a mug because we have no dishes and I'm lazy. And while I'm eating, both my snakes are eating. So we have treats. And he's eating there. Sorry, it's a bit weird because there's lights on. That was cute. My little son and I eating together. Alright, so I've just showered. I'm gonna go to bed. And by going to bed, I mean I'm gonna lie in bed for like 4 hours until it's 4 a.m. And then pass out from exhaustion. That's okay. It's not like I have to be up at like 8:30 tomorrow or anything. I do. I hope you guys have a really fantastic rest of your day. And I will talk to you guys tomorrow. Bye!
Go!
Precious little face. Look at him. Dickie!